ವೇದಿಕೆಯ ಮೇಲೆ ವೇದಿಕೆಯ ಎದುರು ವೇದಿಕೆಯ ಮುಂದಿನ ಮೇಲ್ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಸೀನರಾಗಿರುವ ನನ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆತ್ಮೀಯ ಬಂಧು ಭಗಿನಿಯರಿಗೆ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ವಂದನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಿ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿ ನನ್ನ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಮುಂದುವರಿಸ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಟುಡೇ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವಿ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಮೆನಿ ಸೊಸೈಟೀಸ್, ಇನ್ಯೂಮರಬಲ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಬೈ ವೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೀಡಿ ಡಾಮಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ರಿಜಿಮ್ಸ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಬೈ ಸಚ್ ರೂಲಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಟ್ ವಿದಿನ್ ನೇಷನ್ಸ್. Artificial fissures are deliberately created and sustained by such vested interests to subserve their ends, resulting in gross human rights violations. Distrust and hatredness pervade the fabric of international relations, and the warring groups tend to stupidly seek solace beneath the destructive armaments, conventional and nuclear. There is trauma and tension. Peace eludes the mankind. Hunger, misery, exploitation leading to deprivation in a massive and intensive scale have created explosive situation everywhere. Unless mass poverty and macro hunger are eliminated, self-respect and human dignity is provided to the constituents of the mankind, the disturbing situation we notice today may outburst with a Lebanon roar at any time. It appears that modern states have no mind in that direction. On the other hand, the escalation of the arms race and the consequent cutbacks on social services and programs inevitably lead to chronic mass unemployment, aggravation of social inequality and discrimination, the emergence of millions and millions of poor and homeless destitutes all over the world. Therefore, it is quite clear that only by establishing a dependable system of international security and peace, the world would be able to eliminate the danger threatening the most essential human right, the right to live, without which all other civil and political rights will be meaningless and are of dead letter. The very right to be human is possible only if essentials of existence, material and moral, are preserved and provided to every human being. In order to do that, the world and the states should prevent the emergence of greedy robbers and grabbers and the weak and meek who live and die in neglect, starvation or slavery. National integration remains a crucial issue in India, notwithstanding the fact that we boast of a civilization which is nearly 5,000 years old. True, some of the divisive factors may be inherent in the history, geography and culture of our country, but there are also forces which accentuate these factors. Religious fundamentalism is one of such force, while linguistic diversities constitute another. There are people in this country who hold an exclusive view of religion which drives them into a sectarian frenzy that does not admit of tolerance of other faiths. Despite a shared culture of so many years, linguistic diversities have often generated tensions and conflicts among us different communities, threatening the fabric of national unity. The same holds good for regionalism, exacerbated no doubt by inequitable development among us different regions of the country. The age-old caste system has also contributed in no small measure to weaken the bond of unity among different sections of our society. All the above forces and factors do pose a serious challenge to India's unity and integrity, and therefore conscious efforts will have to be made by all concerned to preserve the same. Even after 6 decades of independence, communal problem still haunts us in its violent forms. This is in spite of the fact that we are a secular nation. At social level, there are human rights groups, peace builders, educationists, social workers, and policy makers attending to the serious challenges of violent communalism. Lasting harmonious relationship among various religious, cultural, and social units of our nation can come through social initiatives for trust building and through cultivating a sense of common national purpose and ideals. It may be stated that every citizen aspires to be a functional and honorable part of the larger nation. He or she aspires to see an authentic reflection of his or her identity in the totality of the national identity. Our problems of violence largely arise from the need to hold on to identity, negotiate identity, and or resolve conflicts among varied and competing claims of identities. Dialogues and reconciliation is not possible until our people rediscover an Indian nationalism that does not provoke exclusion, bigotry, and violence. People need to be encouraged to take up issues of sensitive nature in order to deal with them collectively through the vision of Swaraj advocated by Mahatma Gandhiji. Mahatma Gandhi stood for the culture of nationalism in his struggle for Swaraj and continues